You want to have great LED lighting which can be fully controlled by Home Assistant? Well, take a look at our ESPHOME AL01, as it's easy to build and it looks great too. And remember, if we can build it, you can build it. The AL01 is a 5-channel analog LED controller based on the ESP32 or ESP8266 Wi-Fi controller. If you decide to use an ESP32, Bluetooth is available as well. The controller features 5 channels, which can safely drive currents up to 5 amps per channel. There is an option to configure one or more channels as a digital output, so you will be able to control addressable LED strips as well. The design of the controller allows for a wide range of n-channel MOSFETs to be used, possibly allowing larger output currents per channel. When using the ESP32 controller, PWM frequencies up to 300 kHz can be configured, which is great for filming video. To allow interfacing to sensors, push buttons, etc., 4 I/O pins are made available, as well as a serial port. The I/O pins can handle 3.3 volts and 5 volt signals, and they can output 3.3 volt signals. For flexibility, the controller can work with either 5 volts or 8 to 30 volts DC. When using an input voltage of 8 to 30 volts, the optional voltage regulator is required. Since there are many different sizes available, the PCB allows for a wide range of voltage regulators to be used. We like to make our designs look nice and sleek and not too industrial, so we designed the AL01 to fit in a nice looking enclosure. On our website you will find a YAML configuration file which can be used in conjunction with the ESP Home firmware. This will allow for easy integration into a Home Assistant environment. More on that later. The PCBs can be purchased at PCBWay. If you order from them, we get a small percentage which helps us recuperate some of the expenses we made designing this project. You can find the link to PCBWay below. All the parts are carefully chosen and you are likely to find those in our future designs. So if you order by 10, there is a good chance you can use those parts for some of our upcoming projects. For soldering, we like to use this T12 soldering station. It's relatively cheap and it works absolutely great. Since we humans only have 2 hands, we advise you to get one of these cheap soldering stands like the one we use. It will make your life so much easier. Check out our website to see what tools we use to get this job done. First, make sure you have all the components nicely sorted and ready to solder on your desk. In an article on our website, we outline in detail on how to solder all the components. If this is your first time soldering, remember to take things nice and slow. It's really not that hard. As soon as you manage to solder everything together, it is time to install ESP Home. We assume you already have Home Assistant installed. In this example, we use the ESP32. Go to the Supervisor panel, click on the add-on store and search for ESP Home. Click on ESP Home and press install. This will take a little while. When the installation process is finished, start the add-on and tick Show in the sidebar. Select ESP Home from the sidebar. From the kebab, which are the 3 dots in the right-hand corner, you can select Secrets Editor and enter your credentials as outlined on our website. If you are already an ESP Home user, you can change this to your likings. From the right-hand bottom, click the green plus, enter the node name and press Next. Ignore the device type and just click Next. Just enter some name in the SSID field and click Next. Press Edit and erase the existing content. After that, paste in our configuration example, the one you find on our website, press Save and close. Validate your configuration. For the next part, remove the ESP32 from the AL01, as you may never attach your LED power supply and USB power to the ESP at the same time. This is extremely important, as you will definitely make your ESP go up in smoke if you don't. Then connect the ESP to your Home Assistant system via USB. A new serial port should now be discovered. Select the serial device and press Upload. Compiling and flashing will take a little while. When finished, the lock window should now show your new ESP Home device connecting to your Wi-Fi network. After a little while, Home Assistant should automatically discover the new ESP Home device and drop a notification. Click on the notification, press Check it out, and press Configure. Enter the API password, which is the password you used before in the secrets file. select an area as desired and press finish. Put the ESP back on the AL01. Now attach your power supply and your LED strip. Your AL01 is now ready for first use. If you like the AL01 and you do not want to miss any of our future projects, please support our channel by subscribing and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any of our upcoming videos. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.